Hello, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and today we're gonna check out the Forest River Sandpiper 372LOK. This is a loft middle bunkhouse with a loft above the middle bunkhouse, which is really cool, and an outside kitchen. This is one of the nicest middle bunks that you'll find out there. I'm excited to show you some of the features on the outside, and then I'm gonna show you all of the features on the inside. Sandpiper construction is top-notch, like a lot of the Forest River product line. This is going to have the 5/8 inch tongue and groove plywood decking throughout the floor. It's going to have the nicer vacuum bonded walls. That's going to be both of those things are going to make it so that they last longer, they don't fall apart on you, compared to maybe a pinch rolled wall or like OSB chipboard, which is kind of like the big hidden no-nos in the industry that nobody tells you about until you find out 3 years down the road when your pipe breaks and your floor is completely mush or your wall starts separating. So that's some of the nice things that you'll have behind the scenes on a sandpiper. Another thing that you'll really like is this is black paint that's accenting the nose cap here. You'll notice that the seam is pushed back 3 or 4 inches here. What that does is it makes it so that you're less likely to have problems and issues where it's right there on the cap where all your wind and hail and rain is going to hit right there. Instead, it's moved back where it's not going to be nearly as an issue. Also, you'll notice this is cut in, so if you have a standard 6.5 foot bed, this is going to be a little bit easier to make those tight corners without putting this into the cab of your truck. Weight wise, this weighs 13,062 pounds. And then on top of that, you're gonna have about 2,300 pounds worth of cargo carrying capacity. So you'll need to be able to pull around just over 16,000 pounds worth of stuff. Also, construction wise, you'll notice that they've put a seam here. That way you don't have a crack down where your slide out meets. This gives it a lot of strength and flexibility. This also has the hurricane straps in the ceilings where it connects to the wall, again, to give you a lot of strength and flexibility as you're moving it down the road. So again, just well-built coach. Over here, I wanted to show you, this does have the 6-point auto level system. So this is the little instruction manual to be able to do everything. And those are the buttons that you use to push, to be able to just push a button and it levels itself. It's very easy. Also, you'll notice this storage is a lot bigger than a lot of the competition. That's because this has what's called the Z frame. It gives you about twice as much storage when you can pass through here. Also, it's all aluminum framed throughout the floor and the walls so that you're going to have less problems with rot and stuff like that, whereas aluminum won't rot. 10,000 gallon water filtration system that filters all the water in the entire unit. Satellite hookups, water and fresh water fill. You also have a black tank flush on this, so it filters all the, or I'm sorry, sprays out all the water in your sewage tank, and then all your connections can go straight through this hole, and so that you can keep this door closed. You also have a light inside here to be able to see what you're doing, and then an outside shower also if you want to be able to spray some stuff off. Not only on this side, but you also have a sprayer on the other side. So if you want to spray off right before you go inside or spray off your picnic table, you can do that. I also wanted to make sure you know that this is a fully enclosed underbelly. These are the valves for your gray and black tank. And it's nice that they've actually labeled the tanks and which ones they are. This fully enclosed underbelly does have a heated system to protect those tanks. And then you have a 10-gallon water heater that will give you up to 16.2 gallons of hot water per hour. That's because it can run off both gas and electric at the same time if you need that quick recovery rate. Over here, you'll notice that there is a port to be able to add a backup camera if you decide to do that. We carry those in our parts store. You also have an outside grill that has a quick connect to the propane. That makes it very easy and convenient that you can utilize that with your outside kitchen. So over here, this pops up. You have a 110 fridge. You also have some nice cabinetry with the hidden hinges. You have a metal bottom, so if you do get a little bit of water on here, it's not a big deal. And then you also have a sink that is ported into the galley tank. So that's nice. Instead of having to take the bowl out each time and dump it, you can just hook right into here. You also have some nice lights that you can turn on and off, as well as a GFI protected outlet as well. Over here, wanted to show you that this does have the Equiflex suspension system. This is a nicer suspension system as opposed to just a plain old leaf spring suspension system that is going to give you a much smoother ride. And here's that extra port I was telling you about. So if you wanted to rinse off your stairs or whatever, you can do that. 110 outlet, outside speakers, secondary access to that pass-through storage. These stairs are super nice. As you can see, they're very sturdy, and these also have the spring assist, so you can have it help you get these stairs up into the coach. And then these are going to feel a lot more sturdy as you go in. All right, so come on inside. We're going to pass by the middle bunkhouse area first, but then let's go start off in the living room. I want to show you how open this is. And the benefit of doing a bunkhouse in the middle as opposed to the end, a lot of times bunkhouses are great because they sleep enough people, but they are not as good because, unfortunately, it kills all your great views out the back. This being a middle bunkhouse, you get all the benefits of a super nice living room with the extra sleeping capacity. This does come with a TV. We've just taken it out at the moment for security reasons. But this, yeah, it is on a swing arm. You can see it from both couches. Actually, this one's a couch that folds into a bed. So if you needed to have an extra place to sleep, you can fold this into a nice queen size bed, or full size bed, I should say. So you can easily fit two adults. And then over here is the nice Thomas Paine heat massage cup holder light recliner. So you can pull this little button. You can even lean back a little bit if I was a little bit further away from that window. And then the table comes out, and there's two of these that come with it, and they're nice just to keep your cold drink, or I guess you have a drink. I don't know what you put here. All kinds of stuff. Maybe your cell phone or whatever. These are blackout shades in the slow rise, so they work really nice. All the windows are openable, with the exception of a couple, like this big huge window back here. All LED lights throughout the entire coach. That's going to make it so that they burn a lot cooler, so that they're not fighting your AC as much, and they're going to be a little bit brighter as well. There is like individual light controls on these back ones too. And then when you're sitting down reading a book, instead of having to reach up there to do it, you can just click a button and be able to see what you're doing. A couple other things to mention on the entertainment system. This does have a DVD player, a USB port to be able to charge something, an auxiliary port, as well as Bluetooth connectivity, and a fireplace. So that's an electric fireplace with an electric heater. So if you want to be able to heat up this room without burning through your propane, you can do that. Over here, this is the booth dinette. So the nice thing about a booth is, again, you can turn it into a bed. So you can really sleep 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 people in this one if you wanted to. So a lot of sleeping capacity for this. The other benefit of the booth is a little bit softer, cushier cushions. And then these come off, and then you have a big piece of plywood underneath here instead of just a piece of cardboard. So again, this is not gonna bow as much over time, and they're using the same stuff in here as they are for the floors. And it makes it so that they don't have to put special supports into the area here. So if you have a big sleeping bag or something like that, you're not having to like squeeze past those supports, because they're actually doing it the right way by putting a big piece of plywood to work with. Over here in the kitchen, you'll notice this is the island kitchen, so you have this extend out quite a bit, so that you have lots of counter space to work with. Aluminum sink, as well as stainless steel And this is very wide, as you can see, with it's a 60-40 type split. This is all solid surface countertops. So if you have the bigger pots and pans to wash, you can be able to do that a lot easier. Also, this is the new style oven that they're using. This has a glass front so that you can see what you're doing, and a light that lights up. And again, just nice accent lights, nicer grate on top here. This has the spring assist for the glass top that makes it flush. Again, just for extra counter space to work with. You also have some decent pantry areas. Again, nice hidden hinges throughout. And then these are the soft close drawers as well. Large residential microwave so that you can fit your real size plates instead of these tiny saucer plates in your microwave to heat stuff up. And then over here, this is an electric fridge. It's a 20 cubic foot electric. The beauty of going to electric is a couple things. One, it's going to be more efficient than a gas electric because it's only using one way to heat up or cool down the unit. And two, it's going to be a lot bigger, so you can put a lot more food in there. And of course, being able to fit up to 11 people, that might come in super handy. Also, this has a built-in inverter, so if you want to be able to run that off the battery or plugged in, you can do that. And that's one of the beauties of going to an electric system. Wine rack on top if you decide to use it that way. And again, just nice lighting above the dinette. Nice wood throughout, and notice how tall the slide outs are as well. So you got plenty of height to make this feel a lot more open and big. Dual zone control for your AC and furnace. So all you do is push one button or one console to be able to control everything in the entire unit. So this does have both a living room and a bedroom AC. Now let's move into the middle bunkhouse. This is super cool. The kids will love it for several reasons. One, this does turn into a bed, and then this turns into a bed as well. So if you need that, and then that you have an emergency exit if you need to get out of here in a hurry. You can also put this up on both sides so that you can turn this into a cool couch. And this is what the kids will love. You turn this up and you can lock it in place, and then after that, look at all the USB. You have two USB ports, 110 outlet here, 110 outlet over here, 110 outlet over there. This even folds down into a couple cup holders. And so it's one of the ones that has the most outlets out of any of the competition. And then you have TV hookups for both satellite, antenna, cable, all of that built into here, as well as they have decent drawer space too to work with. So lots of options, nice LED lights throughout the entire room here. Passing out of the middle bunk room, you also have a loft up here. So these stairs come out, so you can get little tykes up there if they want to, and they love that little cave area that they're kind of hanging out with this teddy bear soft top. And then just so you know, they have all the controls inside here for some light switches, and also a little tiny mini iPad like deal here that you can be able to control, like your 6-point leveling system, your lighting, your awning, slides, all of that can be controlled from one setup. So as you can see, as you come up here, you have night lights both for the ladder and the stairs, and an awesome size loft that even kids that are a little bit taller can fit inside there, and then they have their own window. Moving on into the bathroom, you'll notice they didn't skimp on the bathroom either. They have a nice shower head here. They also have a spot where you can sit. Plenty of room with a trifold or sliding glass door. Large mirror, lots of sink space actually to work with. Side linen or medicine cabinet area, as well as a linen spot up here, towel rack, porcelain commode, all LED lights throughout the entire coach. Moving on to the bedroom area, you'll notice that this is a king size mattress with the little tiny spots to put like your cell phone or what have you, glasses. And then you do have an outlet on this side. Both windows open up on the sides, as well as the back window over here. So if you want to be able to, this is a lot more sturdy than some of the competition too. It's just a little bit thicker. So again, this opens up. You also have the blackout shade if you want to be able to cut out a lot of the light. TV hookups. This is the TV antenna that can rotate if you decide to use your TV antenna on top. And again, they don't skimp out on the drawers here. These are nice, soft, closed drawers throughout. This does lift up if you need some extra space for like a blanket or a pillow. And then you do have a couple things in here. One, you have a spot for washer dryer prep. You can even do a stackable washer dryer in here if you decide to go that route. And then shoe spots as well as hanging spots. This is removable if you decided to put something bigger in here. I don't know what you do, but most likely you just leave it just as is. Large mirrors across the front. And a light inside the closet. So that's the Sandpiper 379LOK. Another thing that I really like to mention about this is, this being a middle bunkhouse, a lot of the competition is gonna be at a much higher price point. You can save about $10,000 on this model compared to a lot of the ones that are similar sized units. You can do a lot with that $10,000, whether that's a set of generators, that's a set of solar panels, you name it. That's a lot of money. So to be able to have a full size profile fifth wheel with this many slide outs and this much room is pretty impressive at the price point that it's at. If you want to see the price, you can click on the link in our little description here, and that'll take you to our latest price on this unit. Also, if you want some other models that are maybe a little bit smaller or different, you can go to our website, thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. We have financing set up, we can do trade-ins, anything that you need help with. You can also reach us by phone, 970-313-4337. You can also shoot me an email at sales@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. Guys, thanks for joining. Hit the like button, that really helps me out. I appreciate you guys. And also hit the subscribe button. I'm gonna have a lot more videos of different floor plans coming up. And if you wanna be able to get an alert about when those come out, hit that subscribe. Thanks guys, have a great day.